Rose is the most persevering, resourceful person I have probably ever known. And when she says she never gives up, she means it.
I was a Holocaust survivor, and I had to fight in order to overcome all that I went through in order to survive.
So we received Miss Williams here for physical therapy and occupational therapy after she had fallen down and had a hip fracture.
She is one of the toughest people that I've ever met. She always was ready for therapy when I walked in the door. She was driven to get better.
After two denials from her insurance company, the administration at Stone Oak said, she needs rehab, she's worth rehab, we're sending her there, and we're not feeling with this anymore, we're sending her there today. And I honestly think, and will always believe, if she had not gone to rehab, well, I know without a doubt, she would not be walking. She would not have her life back. She would not be back in her own condo. That would not happen. And I'm really not at all sure she'd be with us right now.
We get a lot of people here who have had a fall and have ended up either with a head injury or a broken bone. And so with physical therapy, you just try to get them up on their feet, keep their muscles strong and active so that they can have a normal life again.
Were it not for the rehab, I don't think I would be in the condition that I'm right now. They taught me so many things that up to now I'm still using it. Were it not for those that they taught me, I would not have been able to go into bed and not get into the car and stuff like that.
Rose is an inspiration, simply put. I mean, to be able to continue to persevere for independence, to want to be better, even when you're above 90 years old, even after you've sustained injury and illness and you still have that drive. I mean, it's inspiring to me. I think she has more drive than a lot of 20-year-olds I know. So it was really fun to work with her because you knew that she was always going to be ready for therapy.
Outcome in the rehab program is 90% between your ears. Like, all right, if you believe that you're going to get well, you're going to get well. And she was determined from the very beginning that she was going to go home and return to all of her other activities. And I really think that's her mission in life, is to just continue to spread her story to the younger generation so that they will never forget what happened. And she had to get back to doing that again.